G'day, Andrew Wagoner here from Aquila Property Investment. I wanted to talk to you this morning about the Commonwealth Games on the Gold Coast. Now, lots of people ask me, look, should we invest on the Gold Coast because of the Commonwealth Games? Now, the Commonwealth Games do mean something to the Gold Coast economy, there's no doubt. There's about $1 billion worth of infrastructure spending that's occurring, and that is creating some good economic growth here on the coast, and is likely to boost visitor numbers in 2018 and beyond. However, it's only one small part of what is happening on the Gold Coast. So if we look at the economic boom that's occurred on the coast in the last 3 to 4 years, which has really driven down the unemployment rate, pushed up wages, and created a lot of new jobs here, around 30,000 jobs, then we've got to look at the wider picture, and that picture is much bigger than the Commonwealth Games. So we're talking about infrastructure spending on things like the light rail, on the M1, on various transport routes on the coast, and in particular on some big projects like the Gold Coast Hospital, lots of big new residential towers, particularly up north. We're talking actually a total figure of around $13 to $14 billion. So that's been over the last 3 to 4 years, and that's really propelled lots of the economic growth that's occurred here on the coast. So the Commonwealth Games is a part of that, but it's a relatively small part, 1 billion out of 13 to 14 billion. So that puts it into perspective a little bit, and it should mean that you shouldn't buy property on the Gold Coast purely because of the Commonwealth Games, but it also means that just after the Commonwealth Games are finished, there's not likely to be a huge bust here in the Gold Coast economy. There's lots more happening than the Commonwealth Games, and so you need a more nuanced and broader understanding of the Gold Coast, its economy and its housing market, before you make a decision on investing here.